Thank you for joining NextLabs. Today's topic, we will be discussing dynamic authorization management as it relates to SAP S4HANA and ECC. In the first part of our demonstration, we're going to concentrate on an S4HANA demo, which will cover cost center and profit center and being able to filter out specific information within those particular applications. The two users that we will be using is Adam and Jane. Each have different titles, different citizenship. One has no filter applied to that particular individual, the other one does. So in this case, we're going to start with Adam, who does not have a filter applied. Adam wants to go in and look at the managed cost centers that he's able to see. He will choose that tile from within SAP, bring up the screen that now allows him to do a search. He'll go through, pick the search engine that he wants to click from. In this case, he wants to look at all cost centers. He's going to pick and checkbox all of them to see. Then he'll press OK and then go, and that's going to give him his listing back. So in this case, Adam has 13 cost centers, and the one to note is the top one of the 13 that are listed here, the 1710110. He's able to see that particular cost center. At that point, Adam's going to go back to the home screen and now sign out. So now we have Jane coming in, also wanting to go to the managed cost centers. She again selects that same particular application tile, does a search for the cost centers, similar to what Adam did. So she's performing the same functions within the same screens that Adam was just previously doing. In this case, you'll note that when it comes back, Jane in this case only has 12 results that are returned, not 13. The one that's not there is the 1710110 that is not visible and shown to Jane in this particular case. She doesn't have access to it, and she doesn't even know it exists because it doesn't come back within the display. Here we're seeing Adam on the second part of this, where he wants to go in and now look at profit center or profit cost centers. Again, he'll do a select and press go. In this case, he gets back his listing, and note that YB600 is part of the six results that come back in Adam's display. If we now go in and take a look at Jane and she looks at the profit cost centers, she'll do the same type of similar search on those items. She'll also press OK and go. And in this case, Jane gets back a listing, but in this case, she only gets five results returned instead of six, and there's no YB600 that's visible. So again, she's given a list of those that she can see, but the one that she cannot see because she doesn't have access to it is not displayed within the list at all. And the reason for that is within the classification table that's set up here, both the cost center and the profit center that I mentioned previously are set up as classified. So in this case, both profit center YB600 and cost center 1710101 are listed within that classification table. Here we see the policy that is used in order to do the enforcement. So in this case, it's a very simple policy that does a deny based on certain restrictions for a particular group or users that are doing an SAP run within the S4HANA system. In this case, it's only allowing for US users to access the PR01 classified data. So in this case, both the YB600 and the 17110 are both within that framework. So that's why Adam can see all of those and all the information, and Jane is filtered from certain ones that she cannot see. In the second part of this demonstration, we're going to look at different information, in this case, what both Alan and Jane can see and cannot see based on who they are as far as a user is concerned. So in this case, we have displays for users that'll come up. In this case, we're going to hide a field from Jane that she can't see certain data. So here we're taking a look at what particular information Jane won't be able to see. And here's our master data for HR. So in this case, we highlighted the personal data aspect of it. When Jane goes in and takes a look at the information, right, she'll only be able to see certain things that are coming up within that particular personnel data screen. In this case, when we take a look at it, what you see on the left is what you would see if you have full access to it, and on the right is what Jane has the ability to see. In this case, she cannot see any of the information in HR data that pertains to birth date, social security number, language, marital status, so on and so forth. So none of that information is displayed within Jane's window, and she doesn't even know that particular information exists. It's just been blocked out from her being able to see it. So those fields are now hidden. In the second scenario, here we have a masking. So in this case, we're going to do fine grained access control based on the particular field or fields that are going to be returned. So in this case, we have a telephone number and a mobile number. The person that's accessing this in this case won't be able to see either of those. They'll be masked out as well as part of the extension. So there is no information that's valuable for a particular individual looking at this screen if they're not deemed capable of accessing it based on their credentials and rights to get at that particular information. Here we see in the third example for fine-grained access control, this is for customer consent. So in this case, we have employees that can see all the customer data depending on when the expiration date for the consent is up. So in this case, we have two different transactions, 116-113, different consent dates for expiration. And based on those, it's for them or to have the ability to see or hide the birthplace and number of children based on that consent date. So in the first scenario, we see that that user's information is displayed. It shows the birthplace for that particular individual and the number of children they have. In the second scenario, those things are hidden because it's within that time frame that it's not allowed to be seen. So that information is then hidden. Thank you for your time.